So DZRH, the Elizalde.
Look at the bus, it's time to mend.
A corporate thing.
So ang sinasabi ko na lang.
Isang mapayapang hapon, Pilipinas. Narito ang inyong balerina ng bayan, Lisa Macuja, na bumabati sa lahat ng nakikinig sa atin sa DZRH at sa lahat ng nanonood ng RHTV. Lalong-lalo na sa ating mga kasamahang alagad ng sining at kultura sa buong bansa. Bago ang lahat, happy birthday muna sa aking minamahal na kapatid, si Jolly, Kuya Jolly. Happy birthday at happy birthday din bukas sa aking asawang si Fred J. Elizalde. Yon, nag-greet ko na sila. Back in the day, parang kahapon lang naman actually, para magkaroon ng mas magandang oportunidad, madalas mang ibang bansa ang mga classical artists para mag-aral at magtrabaho. Kasama ako sa henerasyong yan, kung kaya't apat na taong akong tumira sa Russia para matuto sa mga world-renowned ballet teachers at magsayaw sa Kirov Ballet. At ito rin ang karanasan ng marami sa aking contemporaries na classical artists. Fast forward 3 decades later, natutuwa naman ako na sa aming ballet company, ang Ballet Manila, kakaunti lang lamang ang nangingibang bansa para hanapin ang kanilang kapalaran sa mundo ng sining. Many dancers choose to stay dahil marami na silang oportunidad dito para magtanghal at tumanggap ng world-class training. At hindi lang yan. Ngayon ay marami ng foreign dancers na siyang pumupunta sa Pilipinas para maging miyembro ng Ballet Manila. We've had dancers from the United States, Russia, Korea, Australia, Indonesia, and Malaysia moving here to become part of Ballet Manila. And we are truly grateful for the gifts and talent that they bring, helping BM to become a truly international company. Apat sa mga foreign company artists na ito ang makikilala ninyo sa hapong ito. Kaya huwag kayong aalis. Samahan ninyo kami sa kalahating oras ng masayang kwentuhan kasama sina Brian Williamson, Abigail Olivero, Catherine Barkman at Anindya Krishna dito sa Art2art.
Sina Brian Williamson, Abigail Olivero, Catherine Barkman at Anindya Febrina ay pawang mga mananayaw mula sa iba't ibang panig ng mundo na ngayon ay company artists ng Ballet Manila. Mula sa pagiging isang gymnast sa Franklin, Illinois, nakatanggap ng ballet scholarship si Brian Williamson mula sa Nashville Ballet kung saan siya nagsimula ng professional career sa ballet. Noong 2010, isa siya sa naging founding members ng Dance Theater of Tennessee kung saan patuloy siyang gumanap ng principal roles sa mga classical at contemporary pieces. Bukod dito, naging director din siya ng Academy at Dance Theater of Tennessee bago siya tumungo sa Pilipinas upang maging company artist ng Ballet Manila noong 2014. Samantala, si Abigail Olivero ay naging finalist sa 2013 Asian Grand Prix sa Hong Kong, kung saan niya unang nakilala ang Ballet Manila. Agad siyang nagdesisyong lumipad patungo ng Manila upang maging company artist dito noong taon ding yon. Isinilang sa Singapore ngunit lumaki sa Australia, naging bahagi siya ng The Jane Moore Academy of Ballet at ng the Australian Ballet's Dance Education Ensemble. Isa rin siyang finalist sa Alana Haynes Australasian Awards noong 2011. Mula sa Pennsylvania, USA, si Catherine Barkman ay naging estudyante ng respetadong ballet coach na si Nadia Pavlenko. Isa siyang award-winning semi-finalist ng prestigyosong USA International Ballet Competition noong 2014. Sa taon ding yun, tumanggap din ang medalyang ginto mula sa Youth American Grand Prix sa Philadelphia at nagpatuloy sa pagiging finalist sa YAGP New York. Isa rin siyang gold medalist para sa kanyang classical performances sa 2015 Tanzolimp na ginanap sa Berlin, Germany at sa 2015 VK International Ballet Competition sa New Orleans, USA. Bukod pa dito, tumanggap din siya ng bronze medal sa 2015 Concurso Internacional de la Danza na ginanap sa Spoleto, Italy. Kasalukuyan siyang naninirahan sa Manila bilang company artist ng Ballet Manila mula noong June 2015. Isinilang sa Jakarta, Indonesia siya tumanggap ng ballet training si Anindya Febrina mula sa Ratna Ballet School at Namarina Dance Academy bago siya sumailalim sa intensive training programs mula sa Kirov Academy of Ballet at sa Bolshoi Academy of Ballet sa Russia. Noong 2008, nagsimula siyang magsayaw at magturo sa Ballet Sumber Sipta sa Jakarta hanggang sa tumulak siya patungong Pilipinas upang maging company artist ng Ballet Manila noong Hunyo ng taong kasalukuyan. Isang mainit na pagbati ang hatid ng Art2art sa mga company artists ng Ballet Manila na sina Brian Williamson, Abigail Olivero, Catherine Barkman at Anindya Febrina.
Kasama po natin ang mga company artists ng Ballet Manila na sina Brian Williamson, Abigail Olivero, Catherine Barkman at Anindya Krishna. Welcome to Art2art, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, first of all, we will go from left to right. Tell us a little bit more of yourself. Where do you come from? What brought you to ballet? And what made you love dancing? Okay. Anindya, can you start?
Yeah, I'm from Indonesia. Mm-hmm. I started ballet pretty late, when I was 14, mm-hmm. but I had known the art form since I was little. Mm-hmm. But I fell in love with it, like really fell in love with it after I saw a video of Makarova dancing mm-hmm. Swan Lake. Mm. So, and after that, I really wanted to learn ballet. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So. Wow. And so you started learning ballet in Indonesia?
Yeah, in Jakarta.
Uh-huh. And then I think you left for training abroad?
Yeah, my first training abroad was in a Kirov Academy of Ballet Summer Intensive mm-hmm. in Washington, D.C. Mm-hmm. And after that, I came back to Jakarta.
Mm-hmm. Fantastic.
And continued my training there.
Okay, Catherine, let's meet you.
I'm from the United States. Mm-hmm. I fell in love with dancing when I was 3 years old, and I strictly told my parents that I would be a ballerina. Mm-hmm. And mm-hmm. I stuck with it
at
ever
three,
since.
At 3, you were deciding.
At 3, I decided,
yeah.
Yes. And I went to various schools in the United States without any real strict training mm-hmm. until I met my teacher Nadia mm-hmm. in Pennsylvania, and I trained with her starting at 14 mm-hmm. every day privately. Mm-hmm. So okay. That was my uh-huh. training.
Wow, fantastic. Abigail, what about you?
I'm from Melbourne, Australia. Mm-hmm. Like Catherine, I also started ballet when I was 3. Mm-hmm. But I was studying the Bachelor of Pharmacy. Mm-hmm. And at 19, in my second year, my teacher was the one who asked me to pursue it professionally. Mm-hmm. So I was a bit unsure, but 19 is a bit late. But yeah, I fell in love with ballet for the music, mm-hmm. actually, because of the expression. Mm-hmm. And I play the piano as well. Mm-hmm. So mm-hmm. music, I think, is one of my biggest inspirations in ballet.
Okay. Wow. Okay. Wow, that's late. 19 is quite late. Yeah. Okay, Brian, what about you?
I'm originally from the United States, from Illinois. Mm-hmm. I was introduced to dance. My sister was a dancer, of course. All brothers, sisters are dancers at some point. Mm-hmm. And I was watching through the window, and I told my mom I can do what they're doing. And my mom was like, oh, yeah. But when I went home, uh-huh. put on the music in the living room, and uh-huh. to her surprise, I was doing the routine that my sister was doing inside of the room after uh-huh. just watching it through the window. So she didn't think ballet was where I needed to be, so I started tap and jazz, uh-huh. Like most boys do. And okay. From there, I was invited by Springfield Ballet Company in Illinois to do Nutcracker. I did Nutcracker and then went to Nashville Ballet in Tennessee. Mm-hmm. And really, that's where I fell in love with ballet, mm-hmm. was there. I didn't have any preconceived notions of ballet. I didn't, you know, watch it as a kid. So mm-hmm. it was just something that through the years of doing it and the process, mm-hmm. that's when I fell in love.
And at what age did you start training?
18.
18?
That's really when I feel like I started my really ballet training, mm-hmm. was at 18.
Mm-hmm. So we have a couple of late starters, yeah. and we have a couple of really early starters here. Okay, so before you came to Ballet Manila, let's go from right to left this time.
Okay,
so Brian, you're up.
All right.
What was your most memorable dance experience before coming to Ballet Manila?
Most memorable dancing experience. I think 2 years ago, mm-hmm. I got the opportunity to dance Albrecht and Giselle. Mm-hmm. And I think for me, it was really my first full-length ballet that I really had to learn a character, know the story, mm. you know, that sort of stuff. Mm-hmm. And we did some Skype sessions with you. And that, for me, I think was a really big growing point in my career. And then it's just, now it's a ballet that I would love to revisit and do again.
Yeah. Well, Albrecht and Giselle is a dream role for any male ballet dancer, really. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay. Abby, what about you?
Before coming to Ballet Manila.
Before coming to Ballet Manila, yes.
Was
it that long ago?
not really. Because I think before coming to Ballet Manila, it was only a year or two mm-hmm. after starting full-time training. Mm-hmm. I think for me, the traveling aspect, mm-hmm. I got to travel to different countries, dance, watch other dances. Mm. Maybe the most memorable would have to be AGP Hong Kong mm-hmm. in 2013, because that's what brought me here. That's mm-hmm. where I met Sir Shaz mm-hmm. and some of the dancers, and I was inspired by them. Mm-hmm. So,
Okay. From right to left, Catherine, you're up next.
I think my most memorable dancing experience before BM was when I performed in the USA International Ballet Competition in mm-hmm. Jackson, Mississippi mm-hmm. last summer. Mm-hmm. For me, I had trained 4 years for this competition, and mm-hmm. it was kind of like my pinnacle. Like, it was something I strove for a really long time. Mm-hmm. And when I finally got there, there was one moment on stage in the semifinals where I just looked in the audience and I was like, it was all worth it.
Yeah.
And it was just the coolest moment mm-hmm. and a lot of mm-hmm. Gratitude for that moment. Mm-hmm.
So you trained for 4 years for the Jackson IBC?
Yes.
It was sort of like an Olympic athlete. Yeah?
Yes.
Olympic athlete trains for the Olympics. Yeah.
Yes. Uh-huh. It was kind of an Olympic style competition. I know you also went to this competition. Mm-hmm. It was a very tough 3 weeks. For me, I don't really like to compete, but to be on stage mm-hmm. and to what you do with the training before and what you do after the competition mm-hmm. is more important than what happens there.
That's very true.
But it was just, I feel like it was the beginning of my career mm-hmm. as a dancer, mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. was that moment.
Okay, fantastic. Okay, Anindya, your turn.
Yeah.
Last but not the least.
My most memorable experience would be when I was studying in Russia mm-hmm. for a year. Actually, they told me that I was too old to be a professional dancer, mm-hmm. but I said I just wanted to learn. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, I was accepted, and mm-hmm. it was tough. It was the first time that for 1 year mm-hmm. I did ballet every day, mm-hmm. like the whole day. Mm-hmm. And that was, but after that, I realized that I really do love ballet. Mm-hmm. It's really, it gave me like an insight that I really want to dance, mm-hmm. you know, mm-hmm. because it was tough.
So you were in Russia for a year, a whole mm-hmm. year?
Yeah. Actually, they invited me back, but I couldn't afford to go back, so mm-hmm. it was pretty expensive. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Okay. Говори по-русски?
Чуть-чуть.
Okay, that was your experiences before coming to Ballet Manila. Now that you are in Ballet Manila, and we open this Friday with our platinum season, the 20th season opens with Tatlong Kwento ni Lola Bashang. It's sort of like a Ballet Manila classic, really, having been restaged, having had clocked around 60 performances in the past. Tell us about your experience now working with Ballet Manila and about to open the 20th season on Friday. Okay, everybody's staring at me, sort of saying, Mom Lisa, who goes first? Okay, let's go from the middle. Catherine, what about you? You go first.
Now that the season has started and this is my first year as a professional dancer, mm-hmm. I'm very excited for the season to start, and especially to be dancing Princess Sing Sing mm-hmm. in the Prince of the Birds.
Yes, Prinsipe ng mga Ibon.
Yes. Uh-huh. Really Tagalog.
Yeah, I know. it can be a tongue twister.
It's uh-huh. a huge honor to dance this role because it's a very heavy story, actually. Mm-hmm. And I think I've learned a lot about myself as I've explored the depths of the character. Mm-hmm. And it's helped my ability as a technical artist, but also as an emotional one, mm-hmm. to properly portray a story, to make the audience feel something, to bring them kind of into my world mm-hmm. on the stage, yeah. and also to give me a glimpse into Filipino culture as a foreigner is mm-hmm. a beautiful thing, mm-hmm. because ballet is culture, and mm-hmm. to learn about it at the same time is a gift. So. Yeah.
And we're not going to mention what the ending, the surprise ending is in Prinsipe ng Mga Ibon. We'll leave that for the audience to find out. Okay, Abby, what about you? What are you dancing in Tatlong Kwento ni Lola Bashang?
I'm one of the Maries in Tatlong Maria.
Kapatid ng Tatlong Maria.
Yeah, I'm still learning. okay. Yeah, I agree with Catherine with the cultural thing. It's mm-hmm. it's because I've done Tatlong Pang Kwento Nila Labashang mm-hmm. Last season, mm-hmm. and yeah, it gives you a lot of insight into the Filipino culture. Mm-hmm. But as an artist as well, I feel like I have grown, and this is my second year in the company. Mm-hmm. I feel like I can express more artistically, like what I want to show mm-hmm. to the audience, mm-hmm. as opposed to worrying about every single little detail of my technique.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And Kapatid ng Tatlong Maria is the second story.
Yes.
In the ballet trilogy. Yes. And hang on, you're the Maria of the birds, right?
Yes, the eagles.
Yes.
My
king. Yes. And right beside you is the king of the birds. And I think the kingdom of the air kingdom, yeah? Or wind kingdom. Okay. Brian, so you are going to be the... King of the Air.
Yes, in the second story, I'm the uh-huh. King of the Air, which is interesting for me. I have known about the Philippine culture. I've been coming to the Philippines since 2001, so I'm not as new, you know, to cultural stuff, but really diving into like a story, which is sort of like the Mother Goose stories of the mm-hmm. U.S. Mm-hmm. It's interesting to see how different they are, but at the same time, how much of it is the same. Mm-hmm. So I just bring me to my character. I'm not trying to be a Filipino or mm-hmm. be, you know, part of any other culture, but bring me to whatever character that it is that I'm playing. And then in the first story, I play Catherine's father. Mm-hmm. of course, they would put us together.
You're the mean father.
Yes.
Won't let her get married to her prince.
But I really don't think that he's a mean father.
Yeah.
I think that he's an overprotective father.
An overprotective.
And, you know, yes. I think he's just, he's learning.
Yes. So he's just questioning his daughter's choice of,
And that's the thing about this particular Lola Bashang that mm-hmm. this particular production is, it's not, we do a lot of dancing, of course, mm-hmm. but at the same time, it's really heavy acting. It's really heavy on the acting and the storytelling, mm-hmm. which you get a chance to do when you're a dancer and, you know, you're a professional, but it's really nice when you get some, mm-hmm. get some meat on the bones that mm-hmm. you get to dive into. So.
Okay. Anindya, I know you have a very interesting character
in
Kapatid ng Tatlong Maria. Mm, tell us about it, especially that first entrance there.
Oh yeah, this I'll be dancing as the snake. Mm-hmm. Actually, it's the first time for me to dance like a mean role, mm-hmm. and I really look forward to it. That will be interesting. Yeah. Actually, I'm also in the other stories mm-hmm. in mm-hmm. smaller roles.
Yes, but the snake, the one who tempts the father of the three Marias to cut the tree down. Okay, more about Tatlong Kwento ni Lola Bashang after the break. Marami pa po tayong pag-uusapan kasama ang mga imported na company artists ng Ballet Manila dito pa rin sa Art2Art. Magbabalik po kami pagkatapos ng ilang paalala.
Programang hatid ay sining at kulturang para sa lahat. Magbabalik ang Art2Art. schedule ng mga inaabangang konsyerto, update sa mga magagandang panoorin sa mga tanghalan at teatro. Narito na ang Art2Art Calendar.
Narito ang ating arts calendar. Sa musika, inihahandog ng PhilFest Foundation ang ikatlong konsyerto ng Season 8 nito kung saan tampok ang Manila Symphony Junior Orchestra. Mapapanood ito sa August 29, alas 8 ng gabi sa Corporate Center Auditorium ng Insular Life Tower, PhilInvest, Alabang. Ang MSO Junior Orchestra ay binubuo ng mga kabataang string players na napili sa auditions. Binigyan sila ng special training sa ensemble playing at instrumental technique ng mga miyembro ng MSO. Para sa karagdagang detalye, tumawag sa 585-3823. Sa panitikan at musika, inihahandog ng grupong Alab ang kanilang ikatlong open mic na pinamagatang Katha na isasagawa sa August 20 simula alas 7 ng gabi sa Black King's Bar, West Avenue, Quezon City. Kabilang sa magiging bisita ang playwright, theater actor at spoken word artist na si Juan Miguel Severo. May entrance fee na 200 pesos. Maaari ring magdala ng isang children's book bilang karagdagang donasyon. Ang Storytelling Project ang beneficiary ng proyektong ito. Para sa karagdagang detalye, tumawag sa 0927-226-5745 or 0917-632-9912. Sa sining biswal, tampok ang mahigit sa 30 obra ng Negrense artist na si Nonelucio Alvarado sa kanyang exhibit na pinamagatang Beautiful na makikita sa Isabel Gallery mula August 15 hanggang 26. Sa seryeng ito, tinatalakay ni Alvarado ang pagkakaintindi ng lipunan sa issue ng identity. Ang Isabel Gallery ay matatagpuan sa Serendra Piazza, McKinley Parkway, Fort Bonifacio Global City, Taguig. Para sa karagdagang detalye, tumawag sa 576-4758 o mag-email mark.sanchezchonko@gmail.com.
Usapang sining at kultura para sa lahat, kasama ang balerina ng bayan, si Lisa Macuha. Art2art.
Kasama pa rin natin sina Catherine Barkman, Anindya Krishna, Abigail Olivero, at Brian Williamson ng Ballet Manila. What's it like working in Ballet Manila? What's the company feel like? What's it like dancing as professionals in Manila? I'm sure it's hot.
Yes. Yes. Multiple leotards are necessary. I feel it's like a family environment. Like everyone works so closely together.
Which is actually very Filipino, being a close-knit family. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And everyone's professional when it comes to working. Like work means work, but at the same time, everyone's established their own personal relationships with everyone else in a social way, I guess. Mm-hmm.
Is it very different from what you're used to?
Yes. Because mm-hmm. I was previously with the Australian Ballet Company just mm-hmm. for a little education touring thing. Mm-hmm. I really feel that family aspect is accentuated a lot more. Mm-hmm. I feel really at home, actually. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's like a home away from home.
Okay.
Yeah.
Brian, you have something to compare to, because I know Catherine and Anindya, it's their first, professional experience.
Yeah,
So what about you?
Work environment-wise, I think it's the same as any company in the U.S. Mm-hmm. Now. Mm-hmm. As far as the workday goes, what we're doing, but I feel like here at Ballet Manila, again, it's the close-knit family, it's the relationships that you have with your fellow dancers is so much more impact mm-hmm. on what it is that you're doing all day long. Mm-hmm. You still have your moments of you're an individual and you are doing what it is that you're doing. But I find, especially with the guys of the company, because that's who I'm with most of the days, except for standing behind Abby the other parts of the days. we're like a big group of brothers. Mm-hmm. You know, we're always helping each other, giving each other pointers, mm-hmm. making fun of each other so mm-hmm. you don't feel as bad about yourself. Mm-hmm. I was nervous when I very first moved here 7 months ago because mm-hmm. everybody's Filipino. Mm-hmm. You know, they've been together for so long. How will I fit into the puzzle? But it was mm-hmm. just like the door was opened and yeah. here I came. Mm-hmm. And that, I mean, it was the end. So now I feel like I'm part of it. It's mm-hmm. not
fantastic.
Anything new.
Mm-hmm. And you're not just saying that because your boss is sitting right across.
Oh, no. No, not at all.
Just clarifying. Okay, Catherine and Anindya, it's a big leap from being a ballet or dance student to a professional company member of a professional ballet company. So what has the past months been like for you?
For me, it's pretty tough because mm-hmm. back in Jakarta, we don't have a professional ballet company. Mm-hmm. So what I did was like take classes 2 or 3 times a week, and mm-hmm. that's it. Mm-hmm. And we did performances once a year or mm-hmm. twice a year, and that's it. Mm-hmm. Or like in smaller events.
Yeah.
But here in Ballet Manila, you have everything organized. All the mm-hmm. performances are prepared. Like mm-hmm. At the beginning of the season, you already know what you're going to do during the season. So mm-hmm. It's fantastic.
And it's dance every day.
Every day. Yeah. All day.
Yeah. Catherine, what about you?
So coming directly from being a student has been a huge transition. Mm-hmm. As you know, before I was working more like in class and, you know, to get strong. But now I have a big repertoire. Mm-hmm. And I have this incredible opportunity to dance a lot mm-hmm. on stage. And for me, that's a great gift. Mm-hmm. But when I first came to move to the other side of the yes. world at 18 has uh-huh. been an adventure, I guess, mm-hmm. to say. Mm-hmm. But I've never met a group of more open, welcoming, loving people. Mm-hmm. And to go to class every day and have everybody in that company like hungry to work, loving to work, loving mm-hmm. to come to do what they do. It's not a job, mm-hmm. you know. Mm-hmm. We work hard, mm-hmm. but everybody there loves to be there. Mm-hmm. And that's a very rare thing to find. Mm-hmm. And also the quality of Ballet Manila, to have the strict Russian training that, you know, you provide for us, really takes, I think, the performances and the level of the dancing up mm-hmm. a lot. Mm-hmm. And to have a company that has all of that mm-hmm. in one package, oh my god, it feels like a dream.
great. So what's life outside of the ballet studio for you, having moved across, you know, thousands of miles to be a part of a professional ballet company?
Rest, sleep.
When am I not in the studio?
Monastic.
Grocery shopping. Yes. I love grocery shopping.
What do you like about grocery shopping in Manila?
It always changes. They always change the aisles. Uh-huh. It confuses me, but I like the challenge of finding things.
Okay.
And the products change as well. Like, mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I don't know. It's just always changing, so it's exciting.
For me, it's funny to see what's in the foreign section.
Oh, yeah.
What's in the Western section.
You know,
just because sometimes the stuff that they have in the Western section, you're like, that's just normal. Right. Why is that so popular? You know, mm-hmm. but for me, I brought my 3 dogs with me from mm-hmm. the U.S. when I moved here. So I spend time with my dogs, walk my dogs, mm-hmm. Rest, sleep. You know, mm-hmm. watch ballet like every ballet dancer does yeah. on their time off. Uh-huh. You know, but just yeah. simple things.
Uh-huh. Do you miss home? Dead silence. Okay, who wants to go first? Well, what's the hardest part about being away from home?
Communication, I think, mm-hmm. is time difference.
Yeah.
You're either talking to them really late at night or really early in the morning. Mm. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So missing family.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I don't think I really miss like home because mm-hmm. coming here has like opened yeah. so many doors and opportunities, and I really love to be here. But I miss my family. Mm. I miss like waking up Saturday morning and seeing my family there. You know, mm-hmm. It's yeah. different, but mm-hmm. it's okay.
And what about, what's the most fun part of being away from home? No curfew. No. I'm joking.
Oh, I get to have my own first apartment.
Oh,
yeah, I feel adulty. Yes. Domesticated all of a sudden.
Independent. Have you learned to cook?
Yes. I have. I cooked last week, I think.
Uh-huh. Have you cooked Filipino food? No.
Not daring. Have you eaten Filipino food?
But you have eaten Alas. Filipino food. Yes. Okay, what's your favorite Filipino dish?
Adobo.
Adobo. Why is that always the answer? All the foreign
it's
guests.
It's just the best.
Good.
The best.
On Art2art. Yeah. Okay, before we run out of time, let's plug the show. Okay? So it's Tatlong Kwento ni Lola Bashang, and we open on Friday, August 21. Details, please, guys.
We've got 8 p.m. shows mm-hmm. this Friday, Saturday, and next Friday, Saturday.
Mm-hmm. And 3 o'clock shows on both Sundays.
Yes.
Yes.
And you can get tickets from Ticket World mm-hmm. Or ring 8919-999.
891-999-999,
sorry. Oh, my God. I know there's a lot of nines.
This is the most nerve-wracking part of the job.
Yeah.
Or you can go to the website. It's www.ticketworld.com.ph.
That's okay. The safest.
It's from page to stage. Hey, guys, I'm doing your work here. From page to stage, Ballet Manila's 20th season. It opens with Tatlong Kwento ni Lola Bashang on Friday, August 21, 22, and 23. And next weekend, which is August 28, 29, and 30. Friday and Saturday, the shows are at 8 p.m. And there are Sunday matinees for the whole family at 3 p.m. You get three stories, three ballets by Filipino artists and choreographers, and music is also all by Filipinos, with some foreign dancers dancing in the mix. So come to Aliu Theater. Join us for the next two weekends. Tatlong Kwento ni Lola Bashang. Thank you so much, guys, for doing such a wonderful job.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you. Thank you.
And of course, I wish you all the best. I wish you even more beautiful memories with Ballet Manila. Professional experience, artistic triumph, artistic fulfillment, and you know, may your careers continue to be enriched by every role and every step that you take as professional ballet dancers in Ballet Manila.
Thank you.
Hanggang sa susunod na linggo, samahan ninyo kami ulit dito sa Art2art, kung saan ang usapang sining at kultura ay para sa lahat. Ito po ang inyong balerina ng bayan, Lisa Macuja, nagpupugay sa artistang Pilipino.